Sir Edward John Poynter was a prominent British painter and influential figure in the Victorian art world, renowned for his classical and historical compositions. Born on March 20, 1836, in Paris, France, Poynter was the son of Ambrose Poynter, an architect, and Emma Forster. His early exposure to the arts, nurtured by a cultured family environment, set the foundation for his future career. The family moved back to England during his childhood, where Poynter was educated at Brighton College and later at Ipswich School. A formative trip to Rome during his youth sparked a deep admiration for the works of Renaissance masters like Michelangelo and Raphael, whose influence would be evident in Poynter's later work. Poynter's formal art education began at the Royal Academy of Arts in London, where he quickly distinguished himself as a promising student. Seeking to refine his technique, he travelled to Paris to study under the accomplished artist Charles Gleyre. There, Poynter formed connections with contemporaries such as James McNeill Whistler and Georges du Maurier. Gleyre's studio was a significant training ground for young artists of the time, and Poynter's experiences in Paris deeply impacted his artistic development. His early works demonstrated a mastery of academic principles, particularly in drawing and composition, which would become hallmarks of his style. The 1860s marked the beginning of Poynter's rise to prominence in the British art scene. His paintings were characterized by their meticulous attention to detail, balanced compositions, and a commitment to the ideals of academic art. Poynter was particularly skilled in depicting the human figure with a combination of realism and idealism, often situating his subjects within grand historical or mythological narratives. One of his most significant early works, Israel in Egypt, 1867, exemplifies these qualities. The painting, which portrays the Israelites under the oppressive rule of the Egyptians, was celebrated for its powerful narrative and the precision of its architectural and archaeological details. This work not only established Poynter's reputation as a leading history painter, but also highlighted his ability to convey complex themes through a disciplined, academic approach. Poynter's oeuvre expanded in the following years, with works that continued to explore themes from classical mythology, Roman history, and the Bible. His painting, The Catapult, 1868, depicts a Roman military scene with an almost cinematic intensity, showcasing his skill in rendering dramatic action. Another notable work, A Visit to Aesculapius, 1880, reflects his interest in ancient medical practices and the human quest for healing, depicted within a richly detailed classical setting. The Ides of March, 1883, further illustrates Poynter's fascination with pivotal moments in history, capturing the tension and drama of Julius Caesar's assassination. These works were marked by their historical accuracy, compositional clarity, and a sense of grandeur that appealed to Victorian tastes. Beyond his achievements as a painter, Poynter played a crucial role in the institutional art world of his time. In 1871, he was appointed the first Slade Professor of Fine Art at University College London, where he influenced a generation of artists with his rigorous approach to drawing and academic principles. His tenure at the National Art Training School, now the Royal College of Art, as principal from 1875 to 1881, further solidified his impact on art education in Britain. Poynter was dedicated to upholding high standards of artistic training, and his leadership at these institutions helped shape the direction of British art education during the late 19th century. Poynter's influence extended to the realm of art curation and administration when he became the director of the National Gallery in London in 1894. During his decade-long tenure, he was instrumental in acquiring significant works for the gallery's collection, enhancing its reputation and expanding its holdings. His expertise in both classical and contemporary art made him a valuable asset to the institution. In 1896, Poynter was elected president of the Royal Academy of Arts, a prestigious position he held until 1918. As president, he continued to champion academic art, guiding the institution through a period of significant change as new artistic movements began to emerge. Poynter was knighted in 1896, earning the title Sir Edward John Poynter, and in 1902, he was further honored with a baronetcy. Despite the rising popularity of modernist movements in the early 20th century, which challenged the dominance of academic art, Poynter's work remained respected and admired for its technical brilliance and historical significance. He passed away on July 26, 1919, leaving behind a legacy as one of the leading figures of Victorian art. His contributions to painting, art education, and curation had a lasting impact on the British art world. Today, his works are held in major collections, including the Tate Britain and the Royal Academy of Arts, where they continue to be appreciated for their academic rigor and classical beauty.